often every other Saturday, every other Sunday on weekends at Urban Underground's location. We're so thankful for them and allowing us to use it. We teach history and culture and everything like that. And so we have somebody talk a little more about that. We want to bring them up so that we can, after pouring libations and such a wonderful job that Brother Tate did, we want to say our morning pledge that we always do, even though it's afternoon. So everybody associated with Wototo, Uhuru Shule, children.
Good afternoon.
My name is Tasha. I am a member of the Wototo Uhuru Shule Children's Freedom School. I am one of the educators there, and I just wanted to quickly just tell you what our mission is. The goal of Wototo Uhuru Shule is to help foster within students a level of awareness and commitment to struggle for the well-being of African people. And we strive to promote collective work and responsibility. Most of us are teachers that are in Wototo, so we feel that it's essential to reinforce African history and culture, as well as current events. And as Mama Dee stated earlier, my daughter, she was there all the way from birth, and she is getting ready to be 18 next month. So Wototo does extremely, extremely well, and it's valuable as far as our brother Terrence's son, and he has been going to Wototo since he's been 6 years old. And so he's now in a master's program.
I'm going to school at Case Western Reserve University in Cleveland, Ohio, with a PhD program in college engineering with classes and all that. So what Wototo pretty much, what I got out of Wototo that I still apply to life every day. Number one is love for myself, my culture, and my people. Growing up in everybody's ancestry, strong, powerful female warriors, brothers that fought and pretty much sacrificed their way to be in the position where I'm at, which is amazing to me. It's like, damn, that's my people.
Hey, say something about this year's theme. You all have this brochure, and if you look at it on that second page, it says, why socialism? And I know it's a hard thing dealing with that concept, because we're talking about an economic system that's the opposite of capitalism. And sometimes, you know, socialism has been dealt with in such a terrible way. We think we have to dress a life. We think we can't be individual. You know, you can't practice religion. And all that is bull. That's just capitalism, the economic system that is for profit for 1% of the population while the rest of us suffer. So we thought, you know, you heard all about and what he was talking about. And if you look at the back of our t-shirt, you don't even have to read that. That whole thing in there, but the back of our t-shirts answers the question, why socialism? And you ask people what do they want, they say, I want a guaranteed living wage. That's socialism. I want housing, guaranteed housing. I want free education all the way up through college. What's wrong with that? I want free health care. And I want political power to be in my hands. I want to choose who I want. I don't want you to say you can vote for Hillary or you can vote for Trump and you go out and that's for your choices. You know, Martin Delaney said years ago, back in the 1800s, that if somebody is not representing you, you don't vote for them. How can you vote for somebody who's not going to represent your interests? So I'm just saying that socialism is an economic system for the people, run by the people, for the benefit of the people. Now, if it's not that, it's not socialism. Socialism means that 99% or more of the population owns the resources of the world. God didn't give any rights to Rockefeller by himself. You know, who put the oil in the ground? Who put the diamonds in the ground? What about the water that you pay for water works? What about electricity? Who gives some 1% of go back in your hole and hide. You suffer, but don't suffer and let me see you suffer. I don't want to hear about it. You don't have no job. You don't have no good education. You haven't graduated. You can't go to college. If you go to college, you can't get a job. You see what I'm saying? But don't you act up. Just suffer quietly. Malcolm said we got to bleed peacefully. That's crazy, isn't it? So our theme this year is why socialism? Because all of us are born newborn innocent babies. If you go to Barnes and Noble or anywhere you want to go, you pick up one of these books and it says the first year of a life of a child, you're doing everything alike. It's not okay. First year of a child if you black. First year of a child if you white. First year of a child if you Asian. It's nothing like that. It's the economic system that shapes you. That economic system that's unfair. That says, you know, I'm the owner. I own and control. I'm the prettiest. I'm the smartest. Economic system that teaches you that is an unfair economic system, and you get it from the time you're a little girl, a little child, little whatever. So it's an economic system that's primarily responsible for the way we act, the way we behave, the way we think. So this year was time for us to say why socialism. You know, why we want another economic system that benefits us. So that's our theme, and we're going to play a little music and then bring in Sister Adissa and the dancers so I don't have to preach at you all day, but you can have fun on this 28th year. 28 consecutive years of doing God Fest. What do I think about that? It's all because of you. It's all because of you. Thank you so much.